Hey guys, just wanted to answer a question that I got a month ago from my friend Chase on Facebook. And this is not the first time I've heard it, and I don't quite understand why it's a big problem, but apparently it's a common inquiry because I've had it a few times. Chase, you messaged me this December 28th. It is January 28th. That's how far behind I am, guys. Sorry, but I'm working on it. He was talking about, he's like, I got my Fitness Pal. I'm working on it. You know, I've been tracking my macros, but I keep finding out that at the end of the day, I'm fucked because I have like all this protein left and no more fat, or I have all this, you know, whatever the case may be. I have fucking like 500 grams of carb to get in. Not really, but you know, how do I do it? Well, first off, we got a big thing that I don't really understand this, because it seems kind of common sense. I'm not trying to talk shit, but if you guys would think of it like money, it's just about budgeting, right? So if you have all these bills due on the first of the month, but you don't look at your bank account until the 30th, you're probably going to be fucked. So it's kind of the same thing this way, right? If you know you kind of eat like four times a day, you don't want to blindly just kind of add shit up for the first three. You're at your refrigerator going into meal four every night, and you're like, oh, fuck, I already used all my fats for the day. Or, shit, I didn't realize all day I've had like 30 grams of protein, and now I'm going into dinner and I have 170 left. Like, it's a little bit of common sense. And I realized like a second ago I said protein instead of protein. My bad. So, that's kind of how I feel about that. Now, in conjunction with that, there are a few ways to go about it. Me personally, I don't like waiting until... I've actually been eating dinner at work lately. I've been packing a lunch and working super late. Like, I'll go in around like 4 to 6, get out at like 10 to midnight-ish. So I eat dinner around 9:30 from a lunchbox. Knowing that, I like to go through my constants in my Fitness Pal and then add in the fluff. For example, I know what I'm going to take for lunch because I pack it before I go. Or lunch, it's really dinner. I know what I'm going to eat for my last meal. I also know I'm going to take the same supplements pretty much every day. I also know that when I go to work out, I like having, you know, 10 to 20 grams of carb and usually like 15 to 30 grams. I'm sorry, 10 to 20 protein at least, and like usually 15 to 30 carb. Fat, I might have a serving, might not. And by serving, I mean like maybe 10 grams. And I kind of take that on the go as I go to work out. And then when I come back home from my workout, I usually have a meal or two before I go to work. And those meals, because they're at home with a fridge and a microwave and an oven, then I can kind of play with things and eat kind of what I want to fill that up. And I'm at home, I have my food scale, I know what groceries are in front of me, so that's what I do for that. So I'd imagine if you eat dinner at home and that's your last meal, which most people do, I realize I'm a rare case, then what, you know, try that. You know, your last, but budget, again, like I said. So if, for example, if I know I'm going out to dinner, if I know I'm going out to dinner, I budget, because I don't, if I like have never been to a restaurant or whatever, I budget like at least 20 grams of fat, at least like 30 or 40 grams of protein, and at least like 40 to 70 carb. That's typical. So again, think of it like money, right? Another way that people do it, I've heard Jeff Alberts do this too, is he knows he likes to eat like four meals a day. So he gets his macros straight, divides them into four, and figures out meals based off of that. That could work for a lot of people. Also, the less thinking that has to go into it, the easier it would probably be. So, like, if you know, especially like student, this helped me when I was a student. Like, okay, 2 days a week, I know that I have to eat, because of my schedule, like five meals. But like Monday, Wednesday, I can get away with three. Well, it's like, I would eat the same shit Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and the same shit Tuesday, Thursday. Like, literally the exact same thing, because I knew it was easy to hit my macros, and it took the thinking out, and it's just easier that way. If you really like variety, you gotta know your foods more. And by know your foods, a tip that might help you is, in general, like the more raw or unprocessed, or I hate to use the word clean, usually those foods are easier to use in calculations because they are like one macro. Like vegetables and fruits are usually almost completely carbohydrate. That's not always, but just, you know that. Animal proteins usually are almost completely protein. Fats, oils, butters, things like that are usually almost exclusively fat. And that's a lot easier when you're making a meal to play with. For example, like if I'm making a salad, right? And this is just an example. If I'm making a salad and I'm like, oh shit, I have tons of protein and fat I need to get in, but not a lot of carbohydrate. Well, I'll use low carb veggies. So I'll use like onions, tomatoes, spinach, and then I'll pump the shit out of, like, if I have a lot of protein, then I won't just limit it to like animal proteins. I'll also add in like cheeses. And I'll also add in like pork rinds, because that's a really good fat and protein, like in a salad with like Wollens Farms. If you have a lot of carb left, your salad, not that you might not even pick a salad, you might add a pasta to it or whatever. But then you might use denser veggies like carrots or corn, and maybe your, I don't know, say you have no fat left, so you want to use like fat-free cheeses, which has carbohydrate. You might want to add real croutons. You might want to, things like that. If you have a bunch of fat left, add some nuts in there. But it's really like, I don't understand why it's like difficult. You just have to go to MyFitnessPal and increase exclusive macros. Again, I know that that sounds weird, but and my last like fail safe, which is really easy for me. If you don't make protein cakes, like that's the easiest shit to manipulate. So mine usually consist of oats or oat bran, Bisquick, and protein powder, right? So it's really easy. If you're super low on protein, just add a shit ton of protein powder. If you're super low on carbs, add a shit ton of oats or a lot of Bisquick or something. But those are, I mean, this has gone on way too long, but those are just some tips, you know? Budget like it's money and be smart about it. Don't wait till the last minute. If it's really hard for you, just take the thinking out of it. Sit down with pen and paper or whatever one day. These are the meals I eat these days. These are meals I eat these days. On the weekends, I can fuck with it. And then finally, just knowing your foods and maybe picking one macronutrient type of foods. Remember, the more processed, or I hate saying that, the cleaner foods, like the things that are from the earth naturally, tend to be more one macro ish if that makes sense. Animals are usually strictly protein, veggies, fruits usually strictly, rice cakes strictly carb, fats if you just need a shit ton, add some oil. But that's the easiest way. You got, and then just like gram yourself to add 10 grams, add an ounce, you know, same with taking away. But hopefully that helps you. But again, if you think of it like money and budgeting and knowing your foods, that's it. I'm going to shut up because now I'm hungry and I'm going to go eat my post-workout breakfast. Talk to you later. Bye.